We're here today at Bank of Dudley to discuss business loans. So many businesses and industries trust the Bank of Dudley for a variety of financing alternatives to suit your specific needs, from short-term loans to help with cash flow, loans to purchase equipment or facilities. At Bank of Dudley, we have commercial mortgage loans, capital improvement loans for construction or renovation. We can help with your business vehicle loans or for a small business line of credit. In other words, Bank of Dudley has your business covered. No matter what it is, you can trust the lenders at the Bank of Dudley with five convenient locations: East Dublin, Downtown Dublin, Veterans Boulevard, Dudley, and Jeffersonville. The Bank of Dudley, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Hi, and thanks for joining us for Dublin Today. I'm Stacy Brooks, of course, over here, as you can see behind me, at Dublin Theater. We are gearing up for a great show tonight. As I've been telling our viewers in the weeks leading up, and of course, leading up to Shades of Buble, it is a tribute to Michael Buble. It's a three-man group. Of course, Drew Purnell is a local comeback. He's from Soperton, so he's excited to be on the stage here at Theater Dublin with his group, Shades of Buble, a three-man tribute. And of course, they're doing this event tonight to benefit TLC CASA, which makes it even that much more special. So in the weeks leading up, it was such a joy and a privilege to be able to sit down with Drew and meet him. We're going to meet some of the other members of the group tonight and hopefully get to talk to some of those people coming out after the event, after the concert. If any of you have watched any of those clips that we've already had on, I know it's going to be an amazing night. This is an amazing group of young men, of course, that now reside in New York, and they've been traveling. They've been in Pennsylvania. When Drew left our studio before, they were heading back to New York to do some theater there, and then heading down to Miami to spend 12 days out at sea. So they have definitely been super busy. They do reside now in New York, so it is quite an honor for us to have them with us tonight, and of course such an honor and a privilege to be able to be here to be part of TLC CASA, a fundraising event for them, of course helping the foster children here in Dublin Lawrence County. CASA, of course, is court-appointed special advocates. We're going to be able to meet with some of those later in the show as well. It is definitely going to be a great day in Dublin today.
Birds flying high, ooh. You know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, and we're feeling good. I feel good. Fish in the sea. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me.
Ooh, yeah.
I'm feeling good.
Feeling good.
Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know. And this whole world is a new world and a bold world for me.
My name is Tim.
And I'm Michael.
And we are Shades of Buble. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I gotta say, this is a very exciting night for us for many reasons, but one is, this is the first time that we've ever performed in this region of Georgia before, which is pretty cool. And another I'll let Drew tell you in just a second, but this show is full of audience participation. So if you guys feel like singing along, if you feel like dancing along, clapping along with us, we say, go for it. Can you do that for us? Yeah? It'll make the show so much more fun for all of us.
All right, well, the three of us originally grew up all over the place. Michael on the end is from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
Tim here in the middle is from Syracuse, New York. And I am from Soperton, Georgia.
Shades of Drew Purnell, am I right?
But now we all live in New York City. And even though, all right, thank you. Couple New York applauses there. Awesome. So we all met doing this in New York, and you know, Michael Buble, he's originally from Canada, the Vancouver area, but we really feel like his music captures that feel, vibe, and style we all know in the Big Apple.
Now, some of you out there might be wondering why it takes three sexy, well-suited gentlemen to do a tribute to Mr. Michael Buble.
All right, so we're not here to imitate Michael Buble. We want to get that out right from the beginning. Instead, we want to celebrate him and the fantastic music that he performs. So what we've done is we've taken those songs that he sings and we've combined them with that three-part harmony sound of the guy groups from the 50s and 60s to create something brand new.
That's right. So, of course, we have for you guys some of his big band Frank Sinatra covers. We also have some of the songs he wrote you guys might have heard on the radio the past few years.
And we also have some of his Motown and rock and roll hits too, like this one. Hit it!
Stacy Brooks here for Dublin Today over at Theater Dublin. Of course, we are here for Shades of Buble. This is a benefit, a fundraiser for TLC CASA. We have Miss Marie Townsend here with us. She is no stranger to our show.
Oh, no.
We appreciate what she does over at CASA. Now, Miss Marie, just remind our viewers what exactly CASA is and just how important that events like this really are.
CASA is court-appointed special advocate. We advocate for abused and neglected children that are in the foster care system. We're appointed by the juvenile court judge to be their eyes, ears, and voice, Stacy. And without our awesome volunteers and, of course, this awesome community that comes out and supports these great events for us like we are having tonight at Theater Dublin, we are not able to do what we need to do to be able to advocate for these children. And we really appreciate everybody coming out and supporting us tonight and seeing this awesome show.
And it has been awesome so far. Of course, we're just taking a little break now. Lots of folks turned out on this cold night, so lots of support for TLC CASA. We're going to be hearing from a few more people. Again, Ms. Marie, thanks for all that you guys do, and we are looking forward to the rest of the show.
Thank you, Stacy. We can always count on you.
A lot of the other companies were putting business ahead of the patient, and the main thing that we wanted to be a part of was to make sure that Integrity Hospice, that we were constantly putting the patient first.
They're there for you. They're there for the patients, and they want to do what's in the best interest of everybody concerned.
We provide a lot of services for both the emotional and spiritual needs for these patients.
I strongly recommend Integrity Hospice and everything that they represent.
Thanks again for joining us for Dublin Today. Stacy Brooks here with Representative Matt Hatchett. Appreciate you turning out. And I'd like for you to tell our viewers, of course, our viewers are very familiar with you, appreciate what you do for our county. Now, could you tell us a little bit about how you're involved with TLC CASA and just how vital they do play a role in the lives of children here in Dublin, Lawrence County?
Well, I've been involved with TLC CASA since they came, just kind of on the fringes and helping them. You know, they do fundraisers and trying to help them raise money. But in my role as state rep, we get involved, you know, with through DFACs and with children, and TLC CASA and the role they play with giving these children a voice with through going through the legal system is so important, because a lot of them don't have anybody to give them a voice and to help them get through the system. So.
And of course, we've heard from Ms. Marie Townsend on countless occasions that they strictly advocate for these children. And we know that that there's about 120 to 150 children on any given day in Dublin, Lawrence County. That's a pretty high number, I think.
It's a huge number. And it's and, you know, and I represent Lawrence, Trutland, and Johnson. So, you know, there's even more that are out there that are getting touched. And CASA, you know, if you've got the time and you've got the love for children and you want to get out and help, then it, you know, please volunteer. They're always looking for people to help serve the children.
So now, have you enjoyed the show so far?
Oh, it's great. you know, these three guys, they sing really high. I might be able to help them on the lower octaves, you know. So, well, but it's been great. It's been nice.
And we appreciate you taking a few minutes with us. I know everybody's coming out just for a quick break. Thanks, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the
looking
show as well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
By a round of applause, how many of you out there knew every single one of those songs?
All right, we got some Sinatra fans there.
So the three of us get to travel all over the world doing this fun show together. We perform in concert halls all across North America. We also perform for a week at a time on luxury cruise ships. That's a tough life, right? Little vacation with like a little bit of work thrown in. So that's nice. We enjoy doing that. But needless to say, we get to talk to a lot of people just like you guys. And when we ask them, you know, what do you think of when you hear the name Michael Bublé? A lot of people say, oh, he's like the modern Frank Sinatra. And though that's true, you guys may not realize he's also an award-winning pop songwriter.
Yeah, that's right. So this next song that we have for you guys, this hit number one on the Billboard charts, and Michael Bublé says is all about everyone's dream of finding love.
Guys, you know, it's so tough when you have so much love to give.
Yeah, and no one to give it to. I'm not surprised, not everything lasts. I've broken my heart so many times, I stop keeping track. I talk myself in, I talk myself out. I get all worked up, then I let myself down.
He tried so very hard not to lose it. He came up with a million excuses. He thought of every possibility. And I know someday.
Another summer day has come and gone away in Paris or Rome, but I wanna go home, home. Maybe surrounded by a million people, I still feel all alone. Just wanna go home. Oh, I miss you.
One a line or two. I'm fine, baby. How are you? I would send them, but I know that it's just not enough. My words were cold and flat, and you deserved more than that.
Well, this next song that we're going to do for you, no matter where we are in the world, the audience always loves to sing along and help us out, and y'all have been so fantastic thus far this evening. I know it's going to be no different. Drew, would you like to take this one?
Thanks. Hit it! All right, everybody, come on. Hey. All right, I want to hear y'all singing along. Let's go.
The night we met, I knew I needed you so. And if I had the chance, I'd never let you go.
Can we get some house lights, please?
So won't you say you love me? I'll make you so proud of me. We'll make them turn their heads every place we go. So won't you please,
everybody, give her a round of applause.
Be my little baby.
My one and only.
Say.
Be my darling,
be my baby.
won't you please be my baby? My one and only baby. I promise to love you, and I promise to support you, and I promise to put that toilet seat down after every single time I use it.
A lot of people know you, know your family, of course.
Well, thank you.
Yes. Now, I would like for you to tell us a little bit about how much you're enjoying the concert tonight.
Listen, I'm enjoying the concert very much. I am originally from Soperton, so I've known Drew since he was born, and I went to school with both of his parents. And it's just an honor to see a young man from Soperton to make this accomplishment.
So you came out to support your local hometown, Drew, then, right?
I came out to support my local hometown, Soperton, Georgia.
Now, I know that you're familiar with TLC CASA. Can you tell us a little bit about how you're familiar with that organization and how others might be able to help?
I'm familiar with TLC CASA because me and Marie we go way back friends. But also my daughter, Jordan, worked at TLC CASA during the summer as an internship. And we just fell in love with it and what it does and intervenes for children that are at risk. And I think that's very important because that's our future is our children and we need to protect them.
And I always stress to our viewers that sometimes people don't realize just how many children we have in our area in foster care. And so do you think your daughter gained some new insight by interning there?
Oh, absolutely. She loved it and she loved what she did there. And she grew to love the children and have compassion for what's going on in our community.
Well, Jan, thank you for joining us. I'm going to let you get back. I know in just a few minutes the show's starting back. I can't wait. It's been amazing so far. I can't wait for some of our viewers to see part of it. Thank you again for coming out and supporting TLC CASA.
Thank you. And I want to thank CASA for bringing this wonderful show to Dublin, Lawrence County.
I'm Dr. Manuel Vega from Dublin Macon Cardiology. I've been in the same office in the campus of Fairview Park Hospital since 2004. I usually market myself as being Lawrence County only cardiology group that's available 24 hours, 7 days a week. What it means is I live in town. I live probably 5 minutes from the hospital. This is different from some of the other cardiologists in the area, which mostly reside or live in probably the closest place will be Macon, Georgia, which is about an hour away. On any given day, my office is open and a patient may come in and see myself or see my PA or my nurse practitioner and actually get an answer immediately than having to wait for weeks or days or waiting until that doctor has another rotation locally. The difference in having a local cardiologist, especially a person with all the credentials and all the boards, is that you get excellent care and you get it locally. I don't have a mission statement, but my statement is go through life and touch people positively and make a difference in somebody else's life. That's how I practice, and that's how I live.
Welcome back. We've got Andrea Kraft here with us. She is actually a TLC CASA volunteer. Now, Andrea, first of all, thank you for what you do. I personally know, you know, fostering is very near and dear to my heart, as most of our viewers know. And I thank you for what you do there at TLC CASA. You are a CASA advocate. Right. Now, could you tell our viewers a little bit about what that entails?
Yeah, so as a CASA, I've been a CASA about a year and a half, and as a CASA, we speak on behalf of the children in foster care. We prepare court reports, we make monthly visits, and just form a relationship with that child and speak on their behalf as to their wishes for what would what they would like to happen while they're in foster care, and hopefully help support them in court and through their education and their their medical. We just deal with the children and help make that transition back into the home or adoption easier for them.
Because sometimes we forget that it's very, until you've seen that, Miss Marie and I have often talked about the black trash bag that we see children come in with. And it's hard until you really experience that. People don't really know what that's like for these children. So CASA, you not only have the visitation center, you offer parenting classes, because the goal, always is to reunify a parent. So tell us a little bit about those services there at the CASA office.
Right, so we provide at TLC, we provide supervised visitations for the parents and families and the children. And so also there is parenting classes that's offered, not through our agency necessarily, but we help schedule drug rehab, help the parents in that, just to reunify the whole family and work with the whole family.
And the visitation center, of course, we've heard a lot of talk about that. And that is where children can come in a safe environment and have a visit with their parents.
Right. So sometimes it's multiple times a week, sometimes just weekly. But the visitation center is there for supervised visits. And it's a safe environment where the kids can play and interact with their parents and work on parenting skills that way also, hands-on.
So we definitely appreciate the job that you guys are doing, and I know it's challenging. It's hard. It's hard to see any child have to go through something traumatic. So we appreciate it. Now, if someone is interested in volunteering with TLC CASA, what do they need to do?
Yeah, so we always are looking for volunteers. There is a class that you have to take, but it's not much. It's not hard. You can do it online at home, some of it. So after that class is done, then you go to court and get your certificate and you start speaking on their behalf.
And there's lots of training. They don't just throw. I know they're there with you every step of the way. And I know the ladies over there are phenomenal. I've met many of them. So they do give you the adequate training that you need. But it is just a great way to volunteer.
It sure is. And Miss Marie is always there to answer any questions that you might have. She doesn't just throw you out there and she hears from me a lot, so she gives good guidance.
It's definitely a great support system. Seems like it's almost
really
family
is.
There. So,
right.
Well, I'm going to let you get back to the show. Thank you again for taking just a minute with us, and thank you for all that you do.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Hey, fellas, come on, let's swing. Hey, Drew, you got the world on a string.
I got the world on a string. I'm sitting on a rainbow. Got that string around my finger. Oh, what a world, oh, what a life. I'm in love. I got a song that I sing, and I can make the rain go anytime I move my finger. Lucky me, can't you see? I'm in love. Life's a wonderful thing, as long as I've got that string. I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let you go. Oh, I've got the world on a string. I'm sitting on a rainbow. I've got that string around my finger. Oh, what a world, what a life. I'm in love. Zee-zoo-dee-boo-dee-bo-whoa.
What did you think I would do at this moment when you're standing before me with tears in your eyes, trying to tell me that you have found you another, 'cause you just don't love me. And what did you think I would say at this moment when I'm faced with the knowledge that you just don't love me? Did you think I would curse you or say things to hurt you? 'Cause you just don't love me no more.
for joining us. What an amazing, amazing event here tonight. Shades of Buble, of course, to benefit TLC CASA. Now, I have got some very special guests here with me. I'm so glad that I finally got to meet up with you guys. This is Denise and John Purnell. Now, of course, you had a very special reason for being here tonight. Denise, I'll start with you. Tell us a little bit about how important this night was for you and why.
Well, Drew grew up in Soperton singing in the youth and the children's choirs in our church, and it was apparent from an early age that he had a gift, and we were blessed to be able to encourage him in that and get voice lessons and piano lessons for him, and just so thankful for this opportunity for him to come back home and sing.
And you're Drew's mom.
Drew's mom, yeah.
So... do you think that, I know that when I talked to him before, we were talking about, you know, artists and performers, of course, always have this sort of ideal of what they feel like, oh, I finally arrived. And I can remember him telling me about you guys taking him, you know, to Fox Theater and how important that was. And he was excited about coming here. And, of course, we're waiting to hear him on Broadway, so you guys can let us know. So, Dad, tell us a little bit about, you know, some things maybe growing up that you noticed and how important this night really was for you too.
Well, as Denise said, Drew was always a very talented young man, and I always tell the story that I taught him everything I knew, and then after those 30 seconds, we got a voice teacher. And but Drew was, he was always loved old movies, musicals, he and his sister both, and that had a lot to do with it. And then once he finally got to see a stage production, a Broadway type production, then he was pretty much hooked after that.
So he was an old soul, you'd say?
Yes.
Absolutely. I think Drew and our daughter Margaret both, that they'd been born in the 30s and 40s would have been about right.
That's not a bad thing. Well, the show was amazing. I was able to get some clips to share with our viewers, so I'm very excited about that. Now, does Drew get to come home real often? I know that when he visited us last at the studio, he'd been in Pennsylvania. He was about to go back to the theater in New York. Then he was going down to Miami to catch a boat for 12 days. So is his schedule, do you guys get to keep up with him a lot, or does he stay on the road a good bit?
Well, he does. They've been very busy, thankfully, and we keep up with him, and sometimes we can go see him in some places, and that's been a lot of fun. But yeah, they stay very busy. But if he could do what he does around here, he would. He loves home, but you know, obviously, he had to be in New York for so many of the auditions.
Well, it would be nice if he was playing Broadway and I could get to go there just to hear, you know, that'd be a pretty, I've never been to New York. It's on my bucket list. So I think that's awesome. And I have no doubt from meeting him, a phenomenal young man, and I have no doubt that that's going to happen for him. I can see it. He's aspiring. I feel like that we're going to see that before long. And I cannot wait to bring our viewers some clips of that. I will definitely have him back. I told him not to forget about us when he, you know, he makes it on Broadway. Come back, do an interview and let us see some clips of that. So I know that you guys were very proud, had a great turnout. Of course, it's pretty chilly outside tonight, some things going on, had a great turnout, of course, for TLC CASA. Now, did it mean a lot to you guys that he was coming back, not just back home to do a performance, but actually to actually help someone else, a fundraiser?
Yes, and it meant a lot to them too. All three of the guys were excited to know that they were benefiting such a good organization as TLC CASA, and we just appreciate everybody coming out to support Shades of Buble and CASA.
Yes, Beverly Tanner from Soperton is associated with the organization. She'd been trying for a couple of years, and just appreciate all the work she's put in. And then the cause that they support just goes without saying how important that is. And it was just a wonderful night.
I would agree. I think it was a wonderful night, and I know just how much TLC CASA appreciates it. Of course, they work with our, you know, about 120 to 150 children just right here in Dublin, Lawrence County. That's not counting Troutland, you know, Johnson, the surrounding county. So it was a great night. I appreciate you guys taking a few minutes out, and I look forward to seeing you guys again. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and thank you to everybody who came out.
Choose the convenience of Neighbors Express and get friendly, courteous service every time you visit any of our convenient locations. Fill up with Pay at the Pump, and take advantage of our bigger and better selection of beverages and tobacco products. And buy 12 packs of Pepsi products, two for $6.99. Enjoy the popular crushed ice with your favorite fountain drink. Also enjoy a fresh hot breakfast. Stop by for lunch or dinner. It's always fresh, always convenient at Neighbors Express. Now located at I-16 and 441 and in Cedar Grove, providing farm fuel for all our customers. Count on the convenience of Neighbors Express.
Hi, I'm Coach Chris Johnson of the Aqua Dream Team. We choose All America Transport Services to take the Dream Team to locations all over Southeast Georgia to participate in some really great bike rides. They're reliable, they're trustworthy, and convenient. We love them. You should try them also.
Thanks again for joining us tonight for Dublin Today. Of course, we're here at Theater Dublin. It has definitely been a great night. Now, Drew Purnell, I had you on our show a while back, of course, promoting this event tonight for TLC CASA. It was a big deal. You guys came from New York. I understand you've been out on a ship somewhere in the middle of an ocean performing. So, Drew, first of all, thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
This was definitely a delight for our area. I enjoyed the show. It was phenomenal. I cannot express to our viewers enough. So, Drew, I learned a lot about you our last conversation.
That's right.
So let's find out all the goods on your
all
guys
right,
here.
All right. So this is Tim Courtier. He's from Syracuse, New York originally. And Michael Valentine on the end is from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Now we all live in New York City together. We met actually doing this show. A lot of people thought maybe we were, you know, college friends or whatever, but we actually met doing this show. And we've been at it for almost 3 years now, and we've gotten to be really good friends through that, yeah. And they both have, you know, great musical theater careers in New York City as well, and have done a lot of good shows, so.
So we're waiting for Shades of Buble to hit Broadway, right? That's the goal.
That's shooting high, aiming high. We like that, though, yeah. We would love for it to grow into something huge like that.
Well, we have definitely enjoyed. I know that you guys are exhausted. You have had a long day. I hope that you've enjoyed Dublin.
We have. It's been so good. Yeah. Love being home.
So now where are you off to now? Where are you guys off to?
We're back to New York, and then we're doing a little mini Midwest tour. We're going to Wisconsin and Illinois and Ohio and lots of fun cold places for February. So.
It's pretty cold in Dublin right now.
It is. It's much colder than usual. And we flew into Atlanta and there was snow on the ground, which, you know, that rarely happens. So
the whole town shut down. We had no school earlier in the week because we had snow flurries, which is a big deal for us. Yeah, we're not from New York. Don't laugh. Okay, it was a big deal for us. Some of our children's very first snowman ever. So it's a big deal.
But it
is a little different weather. So I'm sorry that you guys didn't have some warmer weather to warm up to. Well, it's definitely been a great night in Dublin today. I can't thank you guys enough. Again, a phenomenal show. I was so happy to get some clips of it. And I definitely encourage our viewers here in Dublin, Lawrence County, over on our YouTube channel, if there's ever a chance you guys get to go and check out Shades of Buble, it is definitely worth it. Now, is there a Facebook page or some way they can follow you guys?
Yeah, we're on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Shades of Buble. Easy to find. Yeah, so you can follow we'll post our schedule, pictures from everywhere we go, and all of that.
Well, thank you again, and I know that TLC CASA greatly appreciates it. You know, there's 120 to 150 children just here in Dublin, Lawrence County in foster care, not including the surrounding counties. And I know I say that over and over to our viewers because, you know, we need to be reminded. So it was definitely a great event for a great organization. We can't thank you guys enough,
and we
can't wait to see your name up on Broadway.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Wow, what an amazing night. I have had an extraordinary time, of course, listening to Shades of Buble, three-man tribute, of course, meeting Drew Purnell and the others was amazing tonight. They did an outstanding job. It was a great event. Of course, met lots of folks from TLC CASA, got to meet some of the local volunteers here. It was just an amazing event, and I hope that you guys enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed being a part of it. Please remember, there's always lots of ways that you can get involved with TLC CASA. If you will call Miss Marie Townsend over at TLC CASA, their Dublin office. She is happy to talk with you about that. You can always reach us on our voicemail, and we're happy to get you in contact with them as well. But it's definitely been a great day in Dublin today. And again, we thank them, C.A.S.A of Buble, for coming down and doing such an amazing event for us here in Dublin, and for what it meant to TLC CASA and the children that these funds will actually be benefiting right here in our area. I hope you guys have a great day. It's been an amazing day in Dublin today.